As connected vehicles keep evolving, it's apparent that they're going to be connected to a lot of things. And they're going to also need to be incredibly smart. In many ways, you can almost think of them as a smartphone on wheels.
I think the connected car's in a state of evolution. I think as we go forward, and by the time we end this decade, by the time of 2020, we won't be talking about the connected vehicle anymore. It'll be taken for granted. We're moving from not only the connected vehicle to the Internet of Things, where everything will be connected. In the future, the vehicle will be connected to lots of things. Certainly, it'll be connected to us as a purchaser or an owner or a fleet manager, but it'll also be connected to the infrastructure. It'll be connected to other vehicles. When we think about autonomous driving, and there's lots of buzz in the marketplace by companies like Google and autonomous driving, Mercedes and Volkswagen, or Volvo rather, are experimenting with this, probably Volkswagen as well. But as these companies look at autonomous vehicles, these vehicles have to be really intelligent, and they have to talk to many things. So the connected vehicle will be connected to lots of things. So in that, that means the vehicles are going to have to be really, really smart. They're going to have to be supercomputers on wheels. So you think of it as today, we think of it as a connected vehicle, we think of it as a car, a truck, but it's your smartphone that's on 4 wheels or 18 wheels or 40 wheels, whatever the number is. And it'll produce tons of data. I used an example that, the retired space shuttle had 500,000 lines of code and had 12 computers on it. And today, an average sedan has, millions of lines of code and, 40, 50, 60 computers. So these vehicles are going to get so much smarter, and they're already producing so much data. It's a question of what do you do with that information?